We made a tutorial talking about how you can add effects to your particles to get some different looks, and a lot of you asked for a tutorial on this specific one, this kind of quantum eye thing. Hello, I'm Michael Zalapsky, and I'm going to show you how to do it. We are here in Trapcode Particular Designer, and the first thing we need to do is make our little eye particles happen. What we're going to want is we're going to want particles that kind of spawn from the, not the middle of the ring, because the quantum is going to give us the inside of the eyeball streak part, so we want the particles to be coming kind of right around here. So we're going to get a 3D model to emit from. We're going to hit choose model, and the models that pop up, we're just going to take this circle one here, and we're going to give them no velocity, so you can kind of see particles are just kind of showing up on that outside there. Now, we want some nice kind of clumpy movement happening, so we're going to get that with our flocking right away. Here, let's make this loop shorter just for now while we're previewing. So flocking, they automatically want to come in and get each other, but where you can also put in a target point for them to try to get towards, or in this case, for them to get away from. So I'm going to set the target to like negative 200 or so, and that'll the particles will run away from that middle point. They don't want to be anywhere near it by a speed of about 200. But we don't want them to see it the whole time they're gone. So we're going to turn the range of view down to something like 300, so they can only see 300 pixels away, maybe a little bit wider. We do want them to be clumping a bit more, so we'll turn the attraction up some, and the separation can go down a bit as well, maybe something like 3, and then we're going to have them align more as well, so bump the alignment up. So we'll kind of want to be forming these little groups with each other. Let's get some different, more interesting colors going on here as well. We'll pick random from gradient, and we'll just do like a nice, a nice pink here to a nine. We'll get rid of that one, and we'll go to a nice like kind of just purpley color here. Again, we want information in RGB, all the channels, because we're gonna be glowing it later. I've mentioned it in previous tutorials, and it holds true still to this day. So yeah, we'll go a nice pink to a nice kind of purpley blue for this example, maybe a redder pink. There we go. And we're using the HCL gradient interpolation for this one because it gives us a nice transition there between the colors. We are going to want them to be probably just coming up just a bit or going down just a bit opacity wise. They kind of fade out as they get towards the end. And for the size, we probably don't. You know what, let's have more particles first of all. That's way too few particles for what this effect is going to be like. Let's do something like 2500 particles per second. That's better. And we're going to want them to be a smaller size and probably a decent amount of randomness on this as well. So we'll do 83, their size, and for their size, we'll ramp them from nothing up pretty quick there. Just pause it there and have a look at how it looks. Yeah, it looks good because they kind of ramp up kind of out of nothing without just kind of appearing for the life. We don't need them to be living that long, so we'll say about 2 seconds with 30% randomness or so. Just kidding, just somewhere in the randomness of 39 I ended up on. 37, whatever, doesn't matter. And they don't need really any feathering. So look, see. So we've got them kind of moving and clumping, but to really get those particles to get kind of the shapes we want, we're gonna need a bit of turbulence. So we'll say the turbulence can affect the position a fair amount, somewhere in the vicinity of 115 or so. And then already you can see them starting to clump up. We're gonna move the wind towards the camera some as well. Maybe like, we'll just do negative 200 or so. Nice even numbers here. And we'll move it with turbulence. We'll go with the wind. And we don't need that scale to be as large. That is, we want the scale to be visibly larger, so the scale number goes down. We don't need the evolution to be that fast either. It's like 20 or 25. And that will give us something more like this. So nice, they move from the middle, then kind of clump on the outside, making some interesting stuff. Now we want the kind of lines that show up in the middle. So we'll get another particle system. Now this particle system, we do not want to be getting any of that movement from the environment, and we don't want them to be getting any simulation. So that's already native, automatically blocked off. The blank environment block there means they're not getting any of the environment from the parent system here. And it's actually not a parent system yet. So we're going to be doing about 50 particles per second from the parent system, and now it comes from our main one. But I'm going to change that to from parent speed. So there should be fewer of them or more of them, depending on how fast the particles are going. We definitely want them to be getting the color from their parent. And there's quite a lot of them there. But we don't want them to be emitting from all of them. In fact, we only want them to be emitting from like 2% of the parent particles. And we definitely want there to be no velocity at all, because these are going to be the little line trails that happen. We want them to get the opacity from their parent, so that variation as they kind of fade out goes along with it. And we want them to get the size from the parent as well. On the opacity from the parent, we don't want them to be that visible. And we'll want them to kind of fade off as well. So we'll say, we'll do an offset slope on this one. And then we'll say overall, it'll be a lot less. Okay, so this is the percentage of the parent's opacity. We're saying you're going to get some influence from the opacity of your parents, but you're going to take about, you know, what is this, 20, 30% of the parent particle opacity, and then you're going to just ramp down over your lifetime. Speaking of these particle life, I think we're going to want this to be pretty fully random there. So they don't fade off in any sort of like liney manner. They just kind of fade off pretty across the board randomly. And that's the basic setup for the particles here in this system. All right, now we're here in our main comp. We moved a couple seconds in so we can kind of see what we've got going on. And we're going to be applying some effects here. First of all, let's do quantum. I'm going to do these on adjustment layers so you can kind of more see what's going on. We can kind of turn off the different effects as we go. But you could apply them directly to the particular layer itself, of course. And to this adjustment layer, we're going to apply quantum. And that's going to give us that kind of eyeball look. We want it to be coming from the exact center of our comp. And already see, it's looking pretty good as they pull in towards the middle here, but we'll adjust some of these threshold settings, maybe about 80 on that, and probably 100 on the softness, and 3 on this blur here. Kind of gives us a nice kind of more chilled out look. Then we want that middle to have a bit more detail here in the middle. So we'll make another adjustment layer here. And to this adjustment layer, we'll be applying chromatic displacement. But to drive the chromatic displacement, we need something to displace it with. So we'll get in a solid layer here. And this, we're going to name it. This will be our circular turbulence. And we're going to apply the circle effect to it. And we're going to say our radius of the circle effect is about 180 or so. We're going to feather the outside edge of this, probably about 160 or so. And this is just a really handy way to just get a circle. Let me solo this layer just so you can see it. A circle effect in your comp. You can make shape layers and whatever, but it's just a lot easier just to make it here. You know, you can adjust the radius easily and just feather it really easily right here. A lot better than trying to mess with masks and shape layers for this kind of thing. We're going to need it to be going black to white, and right now we've got just white to alpha. So we'll apply a solid composite effect. We'll turn that to black. So now we have no alpha. It just, a solid composite fills the alpha of the image with whatever color you specify here at this blending mode. It's very handy for many things. After Effects, but nice utility effect there. And then we will get some fractal noise. We will set it to be dynamic twist. That'll give us some nice shapes there. Let me scale it up so you can kind of see better what it's doing. We'll scale it to about 350 or so. I'll just type it in 350. And you can see there some nice twisting as opposed to the basic one, which is just kind of cloudy. This dynamic twist has kind of a cool swirl to it. And you'll really see that when we animate the evolution. Alt-click on the evolution there to make an expression, and we'll just do a very simple time times 100. And with times 100, you can see it just kind of gives us a nice little swirling motion there. And we're going to be using that to drive our displacement by setting the overlay of this, or the blending mode of this, to overlay. So it just adds that kind of that fractal noise just to areas that are not as pure black and pure white, because overlay on pure black does nothing and overlay on pure white does nothing, but everywhere that's gray will get darkened and lightened by that fractal noise. So we'll unsolo that for now. And on our chromatic displacement, we'll say, hey, give us that circular turbulence with its effects and masks. And we can turn that layer's visibility off. We don't need to see it. And so for our chromatic displacement, we will displace it by about 70 or so. Already see some nice detail. We don't even need to be quite so crunchy, so we're going to soften this up just a bit here. And we will probably also want to spread that displacement a little bit more, maybe 80 or so. Gives us a neat kind of additional color there in the middle, kind of, because it's the thing about chromatic displacement is it doesn't just displace the pixels that are there, it also displaces them somewhat chromatically. So it kind of gives you that nice little eyeball look. And then over top of everything, we'll get a new adjustment layer in here, and we will apply optical glow, which we always use. I always use on everything. Pretty low amounts though, maybe even less than that. And of course, renoiser on top of that as well to help prevent banding and just give it a little bit better quality overall. And if you really wanted this to look like an evil eye, we could go back to Particular, and in our main system here, our primary system, we can set the particle colors to be more fiery, angry colors. So for the color gradient, we could say, you know, maybe pick just kind of reddish on one end, and maybe a kind of an angry yellow on the other. And then we'll get more of an angry eye look. And we also, of course, need to adjust our quantum colors, because right now we're doing that's good, but that one's not great for fire, because we got the kind of pink and purple coming in here. So let's do Mars for this one. And on this one here, let's do sunset. Maybe that's too pink. Let's do there. Nice fiery red colors there. But again, you do whatever you want for your project.